It's a lovely morning, and I am hopeful that the sun will rise and help us feel the warmth and beauty of this morning, this special morning. Today, I greet you with these lines from Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. It's true that God loves us forever and forever. Let us praise God and exalt him and his risen son on this special Easter morning. Listen now to this call to worship. Morning has broken, but this morning is different. The birds are singing tunes of joy in the trees surrounding the graves. The flower buds are bursting in colors vibrant around each stone. We've come to visit the grave of a friend, but he is not here. The sun is rising in the east. The shadowed graves turn bright. The sun is risen in our hearts. Darkness and death end in defeat. Now we understand what Christ said, what God did. Now we can proclaim, Christ is risen. Alleluia. Our opening hymn this morning will be the mashup made by the United Methodist Church. I don't know the mechanics of making such a thing, but I think it's another wonder that we've enjoyed during this year-long pandemic. Thine be the glory.
Thank you.
Pray with me now. O God of all our days, we come this morning with eager anticipation. We seek to know you, to see you, to touch you. Open our hearts that we might experience you anew. Open our lives that we may be faithful witnesses to your resurrection. May we, with shouts of joy, proclaim your steadfast, liberating love to all people, everywhere. Amen. This morning's story from the Gospel, it comes from all four Gospels. I'll be sharing today the resurrection story, which is unfolded and mashed up from the four Gospels. After Jesus Christ was crucified, Joseph of Arimathea had Jesus' body placed in his own tomb. A large stone covered the entrance and soldiers guarded the sealed tomb. And on the third day, a Sunday, several women, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, Joanna and Salome are all mentioned in the Gospel accounts. Several women went to the tomb at dawn to anoint the body of Jesus. A violent earthquake took place as an angel from heaven rolled back the stone, and the guards shook in fear as the angel, dressed in bright white, sat upon the stone. The angel announced to the women that Jesus, who was crucified, was no longer in the tomb. He is risen, just as he said. Then he instructed the women to inspect the tomb and see for themselves. Next, he told them to go inform the disciples. With a mixture of fear and joy, they ran to obey the angel's command, but suddenly Jesus met them on their way. They fell at his feet and worshiped him. Jesus then said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." When the guards reported what had happened to the chief priests, they bribed the soldiers with a large sum of money, telling them to lie and say that the disciples had stolen the body in the night. After his resurrection, Jesus appeared to the women near the tomb and later at least twice to the disciples while they were gathered at a house in prayer. And he visited two of the disciples on the road to Emmaus, and he also appeared at the Sea of Galilee while several of the disciples were fishing.
Heavens and earth, we pray.
Good morning. We don't have a dog anymore, but we've had dogs in the past. And there's one thing I know about dogs, at least the ones we've had. They are sun seekers. Rudy, our last dog, loved to lie in the sun. He would be outside on the deck, panting away in the sun, lying fully stretched out, soaking it all in. If he was inside, he would wander around the house, choosing a spot on the floor that was warmed by sunshine angling in the window at that particular time of day. He'd stretch out, let the sunshine bounce off him and the floor. I suppose it was warm and cozy, a little spot of heaven, just soaking up the sun as it hit the ground, basking in it. Well, it's nearly sunrise here on our hill. Soon the sun will shine through the trees behind me and it will crawl up the trunks, shimmering in straight lines until it finally gets to the top of the trees, which are mostly still bare and will not be able to stop the sun from blazing forth. Then the sun will begin the journey across the sky, warming us more and more as it gets higher. Perhaps it will be a pleasant day, or maybe the clouds will come and cover the sun. Either way, we will know it is in the sky, whether we see the yellow ball or not. We will know. We will be able to tell because of the light, because of the warmer air, and because we know we have faith that the cycle won't change because the sun does the same thing every day. It rises and it provides light and warmth. Scientifically, I do know that the sun doesn't move. I know that we earthlings are the movers in this whole sunrise thing, but when we are a minuscule spot on the face of the earth and we can't see much besides our little corner of this big, massive world, the sun appears to rise and travel and set. And after all, another day is done. We have this perception that the sun moves. And as I always say, perception is reality to some people. Today, however, we too are sun seekers, like so many dogs we've all known. We are sun seekers because we are at a sunrise service. We are watching for the sun to rise. However, today we aren't just seeking the monstrous globe of hot gas in the galaxy. We are seeking the SON sun because today is Easter. Long ago, very like this hour in which we are meeting right now, several women walked to the tomb to finish preparing Jesus' body for burial. That day, just like this same time of day, it was just as the sun was rising. John tells us that, and that Mary Magdalene went to the tomb. Matthew tells us Mary, the mother of James and Salome, went also. Luke tells us the women went. Either way, these women and followers of Jesus, God's son, head there in the dark, and it gets light. The sun rises while they walk there. But Jesus, God's very son, was not in the tomb. He wasn't lying where he was placed. Matthew said that these three women watched as they placed Jesus in the tomb, and they knew where he should have been. So how was this possible? As a mind tends to operate, these women, whoever they were and however many there were, they thought many things. First, before they realized Jesus was missing, they wondered how they would get the stone rolled away, and then they wondered where the body was. They thought awful things, like he'd been stolen or taken away or something even worse than what that had already happened to Jesus. Although one does wonder how anything worse than what Jesus had it already endured could even possibly be imagined. Well, just like this morning, there was a sunrise, but this time it was an SON sunrise. And praise God for such a happening. Jesus said he would rise after 3 days, and he meant it. Jesus said, "Tear down this temple, and in 3 days I will build it back up." It happened. Jesus had predicted that he would be crucified, but that he would rise. And because Jesus lives, we also will live. Jesus said, as recorded in John 11, 25, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even if he dies." There has been an SON rise, and thankfully, there are still SON sun seekers. We are among them. Several months ago, we read about the wise men that came from the east seeking the baby born under the light of a new and mysterious star. Then, back those months ago, at the time of Jesus' birth, we heard the words, "Wise men still seek him." We have just been through the 40 days of Lent, and during that time, we were seeking a closer relationship with Jesus and his Father. Day by day, if we are wise children of God, we seek God's direction for our life. We seek to live in a manner similar to Christ the Son, and we seek the guidance of the Holy Spirit. If we are true S-O-N sun seekers, we too like to be like Rudy. We will search for the S-O-N, the sun, and we will bask in the warmth of the love and light of Christ. I keep encouraging you all to continue to be S-O-N sun seekers. You can do that by having a regular time to devote to reading and praying each day. It's perfect when it's early morning as the sun rises in the sky. Seek the S-O-N for yourself and feel the warmth and the light of Christ. Today, we can truly shout, "Christ has risen. Alleluia. Christ has risen." Let it be so. Let us pray together. Lord, we are so thankful for your Son, for his resurrection, especially on this morning. We're thankful for the plan that you put in motion for us, and for the forgiveness of our sins. Out of all the horrible has come this, a risen Savior, risen for each of us, risen from the grave to help us live into the truth of the resurrection. Alleluia. We are saved by this amazing plan. Today, help us to feel the sunshine, even if it doesn't shine hot and full. Help us feel the warmth of your love sparkling in our lives. Help us feel the warmth of your blessed promise that if we believe, we will also have the joy of our own Easter morning. Never let us forget that you, God, so loved us that you sent your Son so that whoever believes in him, and we do, Lord, shall have eternal life. Hold close our loved ones who need healing, who need mercy, who need to know your love for them. Give them a measure of the peace and joy we feel in your everlasting love. Thank you for all the ways our lives are blessed. Thank you for the blessing of the S-O-N rise, sunrise. We celebrate today. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Our final hymn this morning is "Morning Has Broken." Sing along.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the red garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day. Mm-hmm. like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
And now this benediction. May the peace of God, who raised from the dead our Lord Jesus, provide us with every good thing we need in order to do his will. And the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Happy Easter.